This is what I'm going to put on this bed just now. It comes out, it's pretty purple as you can see there. It's quite a big model, so I want to cover quite a biggish area. I'm not pressing too hard, just enough in a way to start it coming out. So as you see, I'm going forwards and backwards and left and right. Let me go a bit wider. I have tried this previously on PLA. I'm going to be using this on, this is my first print of this, using ABS. As you see, it's pretty purple there. Now, after about a quarter of an hour, this will start to fade. That's the disappearing. Well, it's been 10 minutes and I haven't touched this at all, and as you see, there's still a little bit of, well, you might see faintly in certain places. I would say it feels only slightly tacky, very slightly really. I don't want to press it too much. I'm going to be starting the print up just now. Now this is ABS, so I'm going to ask for 110 on the heat bed, 235 on the nozzle. So let me just select the print. This is quite a big print, it's about a 5.5 hour job, well 6 hours or so. So we'll be cutting bits out, okay? And we'll have to see how this goes. You might wonder about this plate. This was a quick Kickstarter crowdfunding option. I am not going to talk about this build surface at all. All I'll say is I don't want getting sued, because what I want to say about it, I can't. Okay? So you can maybe understand what I think about it, and you've got to ask why am I putting this stuff on if this is good. There's some sense there. Okay, and I would say I've got a reasonable amount of experience. I have had problems with this printer before, lots of curling and such like. Anyway, the bed's heating up now. I'll come back when it's about starting the print, I think, because it has to go through levelling and auto levelling, warming the bed up and the nozzle, etc, etc. That's about 10 quarter an hour almost. And the bed's on 87 at the moment, gradually increasing to 110. And you can see that this purple glow stick is starting to show back up after disappearing at this heat. Just a second, I want to move on my lights a bit. So we've got this. Actually I'm going to do it now. I'm sorry about this, but I'll try and show you as much of the print as I can. Well, I intend to put this big sheet of cardboard in front here. It's just a sheet of cardboard, and I find that that does help keep quite a bit of warmth in the build area. I wouldn't say it very hot, but it's just the heat off the heat bed, keep any drafts out. So does it. I have to be careful of the up and down carriage here, so that protects it right. There's this box thing here which I have my filament in, spool of filament. There's a moisture gauge and a temperature gauge on the side there. I do normally have a moisture absorbent thing in here as well. I've taken it out because I'm recharging it every so often. You've got to sort of dry out the moisture that's in the moisture absorbent thing, so to speak. So that's getting what the term is, recharging. That is, you just plug it in the mains, pretty good. When that's dry, I'll pop it back in this box. So that's to keep the filament dry. There's a boarding tube coming from here going to the feeding mechanism up above. Can't really see much with this cardboard in front, I know, sorry about that. I want to try and keep as much warmth in as possible. I will be trying to show you it once it starts printing. Okay, as much as I can. Well, the bed's at temperature. And we can see that the purple glue stick is showing up. Probably even darker than it first went on to a certain extent. So the temperature certainly seems to show that up. Let's have a look at the display. 110 on the heat bed, 235 on the nozzle, almost at that now. You can download this. Just put this on light and I'll show you it. This is an adjustable, so you can adjust the angle of it, etc, etc. Printing off the SD card, which is going inside there. Yep, making a bit of noise there, here. So it's just going down to do the auto leveling now. These threaded rods have been quite recently greased, and the smooth rods have been oiled quite recently. So I'll come back when it's actually started printing, because it will be doing the auto leveling just now. It goes on 9 points at the moment, checking the level of the bed, and then it will adjust for if the bed's not totally level. BLTouch down there. Okay. This is my feeding mechanism. It's quick release. There's a thing on the back that I can unhook and put the filament in. It is belt drive. This is what I'm trying to print out now. This, see this section, main body part here of this quick release mechanism. This is in PLA, but I'm going to be printing in ABS. This has worked very well. On the newer model, I've got like a better input output for the filament, because sometimes the filament would catch as you put it in here. I don't really recommend these sort of, well, these particular ones, because sometimes the filament can actually catch in these, like push fit things sometimes, I think, a bit as well. Now, there are pass through types that you can pass the boarding tube through. I would say those probably are better. I do have one of those, and there is one that's actually on my box over here. You see, you might just see the tube coming out there going up. This bottom one under there has been actually forced into here. That's why I'm printing this out again, is because this actually has designed in to have two boarding fittings. So it's just about to start coming into print now. I should have cleaned the nozzle off. I'm taking a bit of risk here by not cleaning the nozzle off. Now it doesn't start actually layering down the filament onto the bed for, well, sometimes a little bit of time. It's very, quite hard with this sheet of cardboard in. I can tell you this sheet of cardboard, just this simple sheet of cardboard here, certainly keeps the warmth in, which is recommended for ABS, and keeps out any drafts. It certainly keeps some warmth in this area down here, because I can feel it if I put my hands in here. As I say, this is what I'm going to say, 6 hour print. Well, all in total, by the time you wait for the pit stick sort of stuff, the Elmer's purple vanishing glow stick to vanish, and then for the bed to warm up, etc., etc., and for the pin to take place and for the bed to cool down after that, it's probably going to be 6 hours at least. So I'll just let you watch the beginning of this. So you can see this printer is working. As I am selling this, it's extremely difficult to keep hold of this camera at the angles I'm trying to do it to get down this cardboard sheet. This is black black ABS 1.75 E3D clone 0.4 nozzle on there. So that's like the mounting part on the right there for the stepper to go in, and then there's some openings on the left here, that's for the skateboard bearings for the hub bolt to go through and grip the filament. Wooden feeding system, and as I say, I am printing out this again, this one with the dragon motif on, but this design actually has two like holes in for Bowden connectors. Okay, I'm going to pause the camera just now. I'll come back in about an hour or so, I think, see how it's done. Well, you can see about 1.25 hours. It does, in a way, 15 minutes of that time there is about the heating up of the heat bed, the nozzles, etc., etc. So you have to say that the print's only be going 1 hour. Oh, don't tell me I've got the fan on. Oh no, I forgot to turn the fan off. Oh dear me. So the fan's on there 35%. This is ABS, not recommended for the to have a fan on. But anyway, I try going under the settings on this control unit just now and changing that. 110 on the heat bed, 235 on the nozzle. You see the 20% infill here. Seems to be doing okay so far as I can tell. I'm just going to go in and see if we turn this fan off just now. I'll try and show you that actually. Right, hopefully I won't get in the way here. Test the button, tune, speed, nozzle, fan speed, 89. Let's turn that down to zero. That's because I have gone from using PLA to using ABS and I forgot to change that setting. So now the fan speed should be on zero here, and it is. Yep, the fan stopped turning there. I don't know if you've seen the fan was turning when I was scanning about there. So look at that side fan there on the left. It does have a white line, tipexed on there. That gives a good indication when it's turning. The BLTouch, the pit stick type stuff, the Elmer's vanishing purple glow there shows up when it's heated up on this bed here, 110 on that heat bed. So this blue section here is what I'm printing out. This is my belt drive feeding mechanism. Dragon more cheek on the top there. This one, this blue one here is in PLA, but the one I'm printing now is printing in ABS. And the one I'm printing now has two nozzle input, well, designed for two nozzle input. This one was only designed for, well, a nozzle. I mean two boarding tubes, one feeding out and one feeding in. This one was does have a tube feeding in, but I had to force the fitting on the bottom, which you can't see from this angle, just the same as on the top there. I had to force the fitting into the plastic, not ideal. So that's one reason I'm pinning it out again, because the new design actually has a design for two golden fittings in it, one on the bottom and one on the top. That's an older one, that worked okay. So I've put my hand in here, I can feel, well, a reasonable amount of warmth trapped in this area here. Not overly hot, it's just, well, warmish, pretty warmish. So having this cardboard sheet here does keep some of the warmth in. Be careful because I'm knocking it while I'm videoing it. There's my box. So this is the stuff I'm, where is it? Oops, see, knocked up cardboard. So this is the stuff I've put on the bed. I did try some of this before. This is from Poundland, this is junk. Well, for doing stuff like this with, not recommended, but this stuff seems to be, this purple stuff here seems to be working well, as far as I can tell up to now. We'll have to wait a bit until we can see if it's curling off the bed. Sometimes it can take 3 hours before we even know it's going to curl or not. ABS, notorious for curling. Okay, let's come back in about an hour or so, I think. Well, as you see, I'm going to say it's 2.5 hours. Fan's turned off there. So far as I can tell, it's doing okay. Can't see any problems. So I've got this cardboard sheet here, so I have to be careful when I'm videoing it. I can't see any curling there. You might see that it does have that infill around the edges. I mean, it has an infill is set to 20%. Might just make out the Z axis there moving slightly, very slightly. Sometimes anyway, when it's pinned, that's to allow for the level of the bed being maybe a little bit, not totally level. Obviously there are times when the Z axis will move a lot as it moves up to the next level, but it's got to move the Z up and down a bit to allow for the bed not being totally level. So that's the sort of stepper mortar mount on this side here on the right. Maybe I should have done a bit higher infill on this actually, to make it a bit stronger. The infill is set to 20%. So I'll I say, it's this blue part I'm printing out now, that's in PLA up there. What I'm printing out now is in ABS. I mean, this works okay. It's just, this one should have a, like a bit more of a cone in a way for the filament to go in. Also, this has two bowden feeding holes in a way for the push fit bowden feeding things. That's this part up here. It has one on the bottom as well as one on the top. This top one here in the blue, this blue one never really had two on. I had to force the fitting in it to the bottom, but was never designed for that. Whereas this one is actually designed for that. I think being ABS, it might give it a bit longer life, so to speak. Okay, I'm going to come back in about another hour or so, I think. Maybe 2 hours, actually. Well, 3.5 hours. I've come down and the cardboard's falling off. Just a second, I'll put this other light on. Putting this cardboard on, I don't know if it helps all that much, to be honest with you. You see, I can't see any curl in there. Just trying to look at the corners and the edges. This is ABS, as I say, on printing onto this stuff here. Elmer's blue vanishing, well, purple. Is it purple? Does it say purple? Washable school glue. Took a bit for this to arrive, actually. It wasn't like instant. I had to send off for it. I couldn't find it anywhere locally. Not even my local stables had it. Surprised about that, but. And I've had an awful lot of problems with this printer causing curling. Up to now, this seems okay. Even at 20%, which this is doing the infill, it still has caused problems. This is, the bed is on 110, the nozzle's on 235. E3D clone there. As soon as I finish this video off, I'm going to put this big cardboard up. You can see the infill there. The secondary centre, we should put the infill setting on higher. Generally 20% is pretty strong, believe it or not. 80% is almost like having 100% solid block. Leave enough, my understanding. You can see the dragon motifs start to come out on this edge here. This does have supports on. Supports are set everywhere. You need supports on this model because this is a overhang here. And there are some overhangs, so that's where the stepper goes there. And this part here is where the hot bolt goes on the left. Yep, when it works like this, I think, and oh, I might keep this printer. I have been seriously thinking about selling it because I've had enough of it. To be honest, curling, and you know, you're waiting 5 hours for a print and then you find out it's going to curl up. It's costing time, money, plastic. I am on a very low budget, so £23 for spool of filament is a bit much, to be honest. Anyway, as we can see there, I think you see that that is not, it's not curling or lifting on this. Purple glow stick. So it's Elmer's. Washable glow. Disappearing. It does purple and it does disappear normally. I think it's a heat on this heat bed, 110, that's bringing back the colour. I And I dare I touch this, as it is above boiling, so long as I'm careful. I can't really feel any stickiness there, to be honest. Doing that very, very quickly there, don't press it any longer than that. I think this is just the ooze when it was starting off there. Yep, so let's get the cardboard back on and I'll come back. It's about halfway through, looking at that graph. Let's have a look. This graph, so far as I understand, is a bit so-and-so. It just depends how much print it's got left. So it's only a very rough guide. 3.5 hours there. 110 on the heat bed. 235 on the nozzle. You see the heat bed coming on when it you get a gap in it, and this has a dot on it when it that comes on. See the gap there on the heat bed? And there's a dot sort of appearing on the nozzle. So yep, this is really very good, this sort of adjustable stand. I can adjust it at various angles. A reset button, control knob, thing for a speaker. It's got like a contrast adjustable hole to do the contrast of the display. Card goes inside there. Good. That was printed on, this was printed on this printer. So if I do decide, well, keep on about selling this, you know this printer's working. It's not like it's totally rubbish. So as I say, I'll pause there a bit and I'll come back in a couple of hours, I think. It's finished, 5 hours 51 minutes. See, the bed's still on 60 degrees there. I'm going to wait until it cools down completely. Well, if you want the exact time, I would say it's 6 hours really. So the bed's on 60 near enough. Okay, let's take this piece of cardboard off that I've put up there to try and keep some of the warmth in. It does actually keep some warmth in this area. I cannot see any like lifting or curling. And if you look at the bed, by the way, let me raise this up a bit. You probably can see there that there's the purple stuff that you could see when the heat was on is gone. Well, it seems to have vanished. So obviously the heat makes the colour come back, and then when it cools down like now to ambient temperature, it's vanished. Let's see. That's on there, very strong. I think it might be awkward to get off. This is just a paint scraper, wallpaper scraper that I've filed down the edges, sharp corners, so it won't dig in the bed and sharpen this edge up a bit. I mean, it probably would cut if I pressed it too hard, but I have to take care. Okay, let's try and see if this will come off. Well, the skirt goes under the skirt easy enough. Skirt is all one piece, that's good. I'm wiggling this a bit, holding onto the bed. Oh yes. I thought it was going to be a lot more difficult than that, but that's come off okay. As I say, this does have supports on, as it overhangs here. Would have pulled some of that off reasonably easily. So look at the bottom here. Reminds me of blue painter's tape, the pattern on that. Don't forget this had this Elmer's purple disappearing sort of glue stuff on the bed. So that's the output sort of nozzle there, where the, well, I keep saying nozzle, it's really the push fit. And on this side there's another one for the filament to go in. So that's for the skateboard bearings. Hub bolt to go through. Feels very light. 20% infill. And the mounting holes, various positions to mount to whatever. So far as I can tell, that's a very good print. Some supports in here as well. Had supports on set all over. So that's a hole for the like push fit on the board and tube. One on there, so that's to go in. So that's to go in there. This is sort of for the nut, latching nut to latch into there. Yep. It's for the stepper motor. Got some adjustment there. Good print. Does not feel tacky or sticky on here at all. I'm not sure if I can just print on that directly again, or if I have to wash that off or isopropyl alcohol and do another print. Yep. It's a successful print. My initial impression of this Elmer's washable school glue disappearing purple, I have to say recommend it. Looking at that, choking hazard.